Jana, and we are continuing our travel around Black Sea coast here in Bulgaria. And today is also going to be a vlog and separate videos afterwards. So we left Sozopol and going to sunny beach, sunny coast actually. And on the way I want to pop up some other towns like Chernomorets, Pomorie, Sarasova, and we also have Nesebar. Right. And I was planning to actually go to old town Nesebar today. Hopefully we can make it, because I don't know, on the sunny coast maybe my husband will be screaming and shouting again, let's go and swim. So he's ruining all my plans, as usual. So we're getting out to Chernomorets, so we're gonna have a look a little bit what it looks like, this town. This is another beach. So this is the town Chernomorets, and it looks like it's not as touristy as the other one, Sozopol, and a bit more quiet and calm. Today sea is very quiet and it's very hot, no wind, and I think my husband would want to have a swim. So as you can see, guys, as usual, this part must be, you have to pay, but I can't see from here how much it would cost for chaise longue and umbrella, but this part is definitely free, I can see, because you see there are no chaise longues and you have your own umbrella. So it's a little bit bigger piece of free beach compared to Sozopol, right? And the sea is not as busy as the other place. And so it looks like it's a really nice, not very deep area for swimming with children. So if you have small children, this might be a very good place to bring them without worry that they could be taken by the sea somewhere deep. So it looks like it's nice. I'm not sure if the water is clear. It quite looks like clear from this side. I mean, there is a little bit of the seaweeds and on the other side, but I think here it's not too bad. So yeah, it looks like quite nice in here, but unfortunately we couldn't drive close because all the way. I don't want to go down because it's really hot and we still have some more places to see today. And parking is looks like also not very easy because we couldn't find any spot just to stop and make a quick jump out of the car. So I presume when it's usual summer, not like this time COVID, it would be even more busy and harder to find a parking place, but it looks quite nice.
Thank you.
pop up to Chernomorets, had a look a little bit. So it looked like, so it looked like a little bit more residential town, not that many tourists out there, except the beach was quite busy and very hard to find parking. So it's, I don't know if there is anything, you know, to have fun, or it's not very big compared to Sozopolis, Sozopol, with the, all the cafes and restaurants and places to eat and enjoy. I think there's supposed to be aqua park out there somewhere. I think this one is more like just for residential living. It's also quite hilly, just like the other place. And I think I thought it was a bit quiet. So if you come in for a rest, you want a quiet rest just to go and swim with the children, this could be really good. If you want to have some fun, it's probably not not a place to have lots of fun and variety of restaurants and food and everything else. So yeah, and now we will continue our way. So I just wanted to give you a little bit of my view on that place. And Sozopol, like I said, is very nice, really liked it. It's big, it's like Sozopol, the old and the new town, and Sozopolis, and they have nice big houses there. I think for living, it's a really nice place and lots of things to do, but maybe for living it's a little bit busy during the, you see the times, like summertime, right, the season time, holiday, because there will be a lot of holiday makers, and it's like now COVID, I would probably expect it's half of tourists, so can you imagine, it was already so many people. I can imagine when in a normal summertime, when it all will be back to usual normal, it's going to be absolutely packed. And so if you will be coming and staying in this place, so I would suggest, yes, find a place where we were staying in the middle between the old part and the new part, but you have to make sure that they will provide you parking, guys, because if you ain't gonna have it, you will have a trouble to find it. I mean, even now with less people, it was not possible to find the parking. Of course they want to be paid for everything, and even paid parking, so they're all packed, so that could be the issue. So that's just a little tip for you. But that's pretty much it. But it was really nice, I liked it. So, but to be honest, as for leaving, for example, if I would decide to leave somewhere around here, from what we saw just at this part, I still like Burgas more, because it's a big city, it's shopping there, foods there. We really like the one place we went there, that Mihana, Windmill, it's called in Bulgaria, Vodnica. We went to the first one, and it was the really good one, so we really liked this. And I mean, they have more other ones, places, of course, and it's the town, and such a long beach and park. So I quite, at this moment, this is my best choice, and it wasn't as busy as like Sozopol was. Sozopol was extremely busy. Burgas is not as much, because it must be bigger. I mean, imagine 7 kilometers of, well, I don't know how much we walked in the other place. It felt quite far too, because it's like, you know, they're walking from the new town to the old town. So, but the beach is also more free parts of the beach in Burgas. Here in Sozopol, it's very small parts for free, where you can have your own umbrella or no umbrella, and the rest of it you have to pay. You see, in Burgas it was free for umbrella and chaise longue, and here you have to pay. And I think right now it's a lower price. I think that was, what was it, 4 lev or something, 4-7 lev, I don't know. But I think maybe the other days, in normal days, it would be more expensive. So that's just a little bit of my notes, what I kind of think about it. So that's why, yeah, it's maybe like the same. You can like go for maybe 1 or 2 days and see what you want to see there. But as for living, for example, I would still prefer Burgas in that way. Well, I mean, of course, unless you are somewhere there and you have a car and you can stay in a new part apartment, maybe there, where you have new buildings or houses in like Sozopolis. They have amazing views out there. I can't complain. The views are just absolutely amazing and very, very beautiful. But the sea is the same. You see, it's a black sea, and I was told that it's not clear. No, it's not clear, and it has lots of seaweeds, and it has like some wood parts from the trees, and it's like all touches your legs. It's always scary, so you think that, oh, is it like shark there or something? I mean, something touches you, is it a fish or is it a jellyfish, I don't know. So that's kind of wasn't very pleasant, I would say. But it's very warm though, very warm and nice in that way, and the waves were amazing. So, oh yeah, the driver's beach we went yesterday, we didn't swim, we didn't risk it. We had a little bit just sitting in the waves in the beach, but they were so strong. And it's actually nudist there too, so if you are nudist, you can do that. There are not that many wild beaches by the look of it, so that's maybe the one, but I think it's dangerous to swim there because we saw rocks in the water, so you have to be really careful. Yeah, that's the other thing I wanted to say. I think I wanted to say something else, but I kind of forgot what I wanted to say. But anyway, if I remember, I will tell you next episode. So.
Thank you.
beach, Sarapovo, and you saw the prices, like 350, some free zones, and 350 for chaiselong, 350 for the umbrella. But the water, did you see the water? It's really dark, too many seaweeds. I mean, first I thought water is beautiful, but by the coast of the beach, it's not very inviting, that water. So I wouldn't want to swim today in there, I'm afraid. It's August and we just been to Sozopolis, Sozopol and Burgas, and the water is different. So here it's just a bit too dark.